Metropolitan Division as they host the Blue Jackets Friday. Pittsburgh is an outstanding 21-3-2 at PPG Paints Arena this season, averaging 4 goals a game on home ice, which leads the NHL.
Oh, a turnover here. Boone Jenner comes to the goal. And a good save by Murray with a blocker on Boone Jenner.
And Jenner with the opportunity.
Left side to Daly and back to Dumoulin. And across he goes. The Penguins will set it up from the far side. Bringing it up high as Kessel fires. He scores!
Wow, what a rocket. And Phil Kessel was able to find room as the Jackets were exhausted. They had that net front presence in the form of Benito, and it did not look like the goaltender could see that whistling shot by Kessel whatsoever.
Werenski dumps the puck into the Penguin zone, but it comes right to Letang, who lifts it right back out to center. And the rookie turns it over to Cullen, driving to the net. He's hauled down, and the puck goes in, and it's a goal. Unless the net is dislodged or traffic got in the way of Bobrovsky making the save.
I thought they called the penalty, and then the puck goes over the goal line. I thought prior to it being knocked off.
Jackets have the edge there, but the Penguins have a mission to be better. But look out, a turnover here, a 2-on-0. Here's a chance for Foligno. Murray made the save on him. He read the play. Foligno was set up by Brandon Saad. He decided not to shoot the puck. Cam Talbot of the Oilers has played the most games. There's Jenner now for it again. Shoots it, save made by Murray. Rebound. Murray finds, they score on the rebound. Dubinsky got to the loose puck and lifted it in. Murray was looking for that puck. Dubinsky found it first to make it 2-1.
In all the traffic, and Mata loses his control and misses the puck. No chance for Murray to stop Dubinsky. Now we have a hockey game.
Hangs onto the puck, swings it to the left wing. Getzel. Getzel wanted it right back. Now Getzel and Fred score! Nick Bonino went to the net, and the Penguins have a 2-goal lead again.
Wow, that is big. A big-time goal.
Bonino, timely goal, his first in 7 games, the first he's ever scored against Columbus in 13 games against the Blue Jackets. Wheels away from Letang. Centers the puck. Saad there, over to Winberg, and he scores. And the Jackets, just as you said, carried on what they were doing at the end of the period right into the beginning of this period. And Alexander Wenberg comes up with a big goal for the Jackets, his 10th of the year. Crosby and Kunitz. Now on the wing comes Murray. Tried to shoot it. It was blocked, and he got it back center. Look out, Dubinsky backhander, and then Atkinson stares it in. And the Jackets have tied the game. Cam Atkinson on a setup by Brandon Dubinsky. We've got a 3-3 game with 8:40 to go. Now here's a shot by Rust. That's deflected wide to the corner. 1 second to go in regulation. And the Blue Jackets come from 2 goals behind to gain a point in this game. Phil Kessel controls. Letang with a drive. Blocked. Score on the rebound, Kessel. The Penguins win in overtime.
He's got a pair in the game and the game winner. And the puck just bounced to him in the high slot. He's got strong, strong hands, big forearms, and Phil Kessel snapped that puck into the top of the net up over Bobrovsky.
Phil Kessel's overtime winner eventually finishes off the Blue Jackets in a 4-3 Penguins win. The Penguins even up the season series with the Blue Jackets and get to within 2 points of Columbus in the Metropolitan. The Penguins had 2 separate 2-goal leads at 3-1 and 2-0, but they were forced to overtime after giving up a pair in the third. Kessel scored 2 on the night, number 16 and 17 to go along with an assist. The Penguins quickly hit the road for a Saturday night game.